Canelo Alvarez says fighting Golovkin in a third trilogy fight really doesn't represent a challenge for him. It ain't nothing new. What up, fight world? It's your boy Ego in the back with some more boxing. Make sure you smash the like button. Also, subscribe to the channel for the latest and greatest in boxing. If you want to become part of the gang, notification gang, please hit the bell icon. Shout out to the Super Chats, channel donations, the Venmo donations, and the Patreon family. We working. Now, Canelo Alvarez, he did a recent interview with Azteca TV, and he spoke on Gennady Golovkin, and he didn't really sound too excited to fight Triple G. Triple G, you know, just had a tough fight with Sergey Derevchenko. I really thought he lost that fight. And this is what Canelo had to say. I am the one to beat, the one everyone wants to face. Ever since Golovkin fought me, what has he done? He didn't do anything. You know, Canelo went on to say, I've already spoken with my promoter. If they want me to fight Golovkin, all it represents to me is business. If it doesn't represent a challenge, I'm not going to do it. If they want the fight, give me the numbers and maybe. I want other kinds of challenges. He says he's facing Kovalev. I'm facing a pure world champion and going up two weight divisions, and his opponents come from losing. He no longer poses any challenge. I've already beaten him. I gave him 24 rounds and he couldn't do it. What's going to happen in the third fight? I'm going to beat him again. I'm even going to knock him out. It's just business. End quote from Canelo Alvarez. And, you know, to tell you the truth, I agree with Canelo. I think the third fight, what's the difference? Like he's saying, what's going to be the difference maker? Canelo's younger, so he can, you know, improve in certain margins, like work on his stamina. Or let's say his knee was bothering him in the first two fights. Maybe there's some type of therapy to give his knee some relief, or his knee feels fresher, you know, whatever the situation is. Golovkin is 37 and he looked pretty bad versus Sergey Derevchenko. So what is his real X factor? He's not going to really be, based on his style, turn back the clock, in my opinion. He's not going to really turn back the clock and all of a sudden become this Floyd Mayweather-esque, you know, float like a butterfly, sting like a bee type fighter. You know, it doesn't matter if he's with Abel Sanchez or Jonathan Banks. I think he is who he is as a fighter at eight. I mean, he's almost 40. He's been boxing his whole life. So you think switching and I feel that's wrong for a lot of people blaming Jonathan Banks, because even if Triple G would have stayed with Abel Sanchez and he would have fought Steve Rolls and then fought Sergey Derevchenko, I don't think Abel Sanchez would have had anything different. You know, Triple G knows what he's supposed to be doing. He's been boxing his whole life. So at this point, I think, you know, kind of the fighters at this level, at this age of Triple G, kind of prepare themselves and, you know, just get little tips and nuanced things from the coach. You know, you got a coach more like a mentor telling you to, you know, take this day off from the gym or facilitating sparring partners and stuff. But I think genuinely Triple G is who he is, you know. So a lot of people blaming Jonathan Banks and blaming him and the partnership and the pairing. You know, I will say Jonathan Banks, he didn't do a splendid job. Maybe that's just his demeanor of corner advice, because Triple G was getting his ass kicked by Derevchenko, and Jonathan Banks was too calm, in my opinion. I think there should have been a bit more bite from the corner advice, like a sense of urgency for Golovkin to put a pep in his step. You know, that's the only thing I would critique. But as far as the performance, that to me, that's totally Triple G and the style matchup. And you got to give credit to Sergey Derevchenko from being tough, because first of all, you have to understand Golovkin is starting to fight more in prime elite guys with some level of experience or name. Sergey Derevchenko had amateur pedigree. He had already had a big fight and a title shot before with Danny Jacobs. That type of stuff matters. Look at Andy Ruiz Jr. at the heavyweight division. Andy Ruiz also had a title shot against Joseph Parker, came up short. You know, I thought he beat Joseph Parker, but they didn't give it to him. So Joseph Parker became the new IBF champion or whatever the case is. So that losing and losing a title shot, that's experience. And then years later, he left Top Rank, got bought out of his Top Rank contract. Andy Ruiz went with Al Haymon and PBC, and he gets the phone call and he shocks the world with the Anthony Joshua fight. So his second title shot, he's able to secure that title. You know, boxing works like that. Sometimes a guy takes an L. Look at Julian J. Rock Williams. He, same thing. He fought for a title with Jermall Charlo and he came up short. But fast forward to the future, he learned from his mistake, got better, improved, and he beat in impressive fashion, he had beat a much bigger Swift Jared Hurd, who was a unified champion with wins over Tony Harrison, who's a champion, Lada, who was a champion, and is still a champion. You get what I'm saying? So sometimes that's what it's about, you know, getting better and improving. So I think Derevchenko just deserves his credit. I don't think it had nothing to do with really Jonathan Banks or his guidance. I think Triple G is just the style matchup. There's a reason why Triple G avoided Derevchenko and opted to fight Vonis Modarosyan when Canelo failed the drug test. So I really agree with Canelo Alvarez. And I think it's almost funny to me that DAZN is so hell-bent and focused on Canelo Triple G 3. I don't know where they're getting this. I don't know why they believe that this is really the creme de la creme of middleweight fights when you got guys like Charlo undefeated, Demetrius Andrade undefeated, both champions, one WBC, one WBO. They look better. They look fresher. They're chomping at the bit for a big name. And I think it'll do a big audience in Texas or on the East Coast for Andrade, whatever the situation, or Vegas or something like that. And DAZN seems fully invested in making Canelo Triple G. I think that ship has sailed, like Canelo is saying. What has Triple G done since he fought Canelo? Nothing. You know, the first name he fought that's not even listed as ranked as good as Canelo. You know, and I'm no disrespect to Derevchenko, but most people would have Canelo ranked higher than Derevchenko because Canelo only has the one loss to Mayweather. Derevchenko lost to a guy Canelo just beat in Danny Jacobs, right? So it would be right to put the champion and the guy with the Mayweather loss ahead of Derevchenko on the rankings. And then Triple G fought Steve Rose. He got a knockout in that fight, but this is an unknown guy at a catchweight who had never fought a 12 rounder. And the first time he fought somebody with a pulse that we know of, not even the biggest name like a Charlo, Andrade, Canelo, Billy Joe Saunders, in Derevchenko, he struggles, looks horrible, almost gets stopped. So, you know, I think the walls are closing in, and DAZN is looking like they're going to end up regretting that investment, paying Triple G $30 million this year to fight Steve Rose and then to fight Derevchenko. I don't even think that fight, neither one of those fights were promoted properly to the point where I think it was a lucrative, you know, sold out affair. I mean, I haven't heard no viewership numbers. I haven't heard them say like, oh, this was a sold out event, like Canelo's fights. So I don't even think it sold out. I mean, if you guys heard him say it was sold out or attendance or got viewership numbers from DAZN, I would love to hear it for either Steve Rose, Triple G, or Triple G versus Derevchenko. I feel they probably comped a lot of tickets and that kind of thing. So the amount that they're paying Triple G, it's just not looking good. And I don't understand why Canelo is being forced to take the tougher fights. He has a better resume. He's younger. And he's being put up to the task by DAZN to fight tougher opposition. And Triple G is allowed to fight who he wants to fight, Steve Rose and such. It just doesn't make sense to me. You know, they're talking about if Triple G can't get Canelo, then he might fight his mandatory, which is a guy with 21 fights and 5 knockouts, a 20% knockout ratio. That's pathetic. You know, I don't care if it's a mandatory or not, because if you fight Andre, that would supersede any type of mandatory. And the guy, Camille Cyril or whatever his name is, he's unheard of. How many times is Canelo is absolutely right? It's the same thing I've been saying. Everybody else is trying to fight the best available competition. Triple G fought a good mandatory in Dariushenko, and then he struggled. Now he's going back to fighting, you know, the Kamil Shizril guys that are looking like no hopers on paper, you know. So I don't know. I'm just off the Canelo Triple G fight. I don't think it's as impactful as DAZN seems to think it is. And I agree with Canelo. I think he probably gets a stoppage or wins much more convincingly, because even in the Steve Rolls fight, I seen Triple G struggle a bit. And it looks like Triple G is just ultimately regressing. Maybe lost some desire, lost some hunger, and it looks like he's looking to cash out. So that's my thoughts. Let me know what you guys think. Canelo is, you know, moving up two weight classes to fight Kovalev. So by way of comparison, Canelo versus Kovalev is a much greater challenge than anything Triple G has done recently. When is the last time Triple G's team said he could fight from 154 to 168 or 175? Yet it's Canelo that fought at 154, 155, 160, 168, and is going to 175. Triple G's team talked it. They talked a good talk and said that they could fight from 54 to 75, but it's Canelo who's actually doing it. They haven't fought anybody. Andre Ward came up, and they could have fought Triple G. He called him Little G, and they ducked Andre Ward. You know, so bad look. Bad look for old media and Triple G. I agree with Canelo here. Let me know what you guys think. Drop your thoughts in the comment section. If you like what I'm doing, smash the like button, you know, the donate, subscribe, all that good stuff. We working. So if you enjoyed this video and want more content like this on the channel, you can show your appreciation by going to the PayPal donate button or the YouTube support button, and you can donate any amount that you feel is equivalent to the value of this video. Much more to come. Thank you guys for your support. Boxing Ego, the future of boxing.